Hello and welcome to Cinema Express. My name is Ram Venkat Srikar. Today we have with us actor Akshay Oberoi to talk about his upcoming project, Dil Bekarar, the Hotstar original series. Hi Akshay, how are you?
Hi Ram, very good. Pleasure to be here.
You are so far, you left a mark with grey characters, right? Be it Flesh or High or... So, but Dil Bekarar seems to be a lighter show. Probably the most lighthearted show or film you have ever been a part of. Is this a conscious shift towards reaching a more wider audience?
It's interesting that you put it that way. I had never thought about it that way till you just said it. So that's something for me to think about now. And instinctually, it feels like you're right about, the wider audience bit of it. That's not really why I jumped at it. I jumped at it because I wanted to, I've always had this thing in me to prove versatility as an actor, because right. I feel like there are actors who give you certain things. You've got certain action stars and you've got certain stars who excel in, certain genres like romance specifically. And when I first started my career, I was looking to do different things. So that I didn't sort of have to compete with all these great big actors who are already working in our industry. I just wanted to do offbeat, darker things that people didn't expect me to do. And that's what I gravitated towards. It was a conscious choice to be the best possible actor I can be. And I think that's why I got attracted to Dil Bekarar, because, somebody came to me after a very long time, after my first film, which was a Rajshri movie, to do something romantic. Yeah. And I felt that, honestly, as an actor, if I keep trying different things, only then will I grow. Like, I feel like if I went off and did this good love story of a idealistic young boy, it would make me better at the darker things I do. It was that. It wasn't necessarily the fact that I thought I'd have a wider fan base. And maybe when you say it now, I'm like, yeah, obviously he's right, because it's more accessible than perhaps, like Gurgaon or Kalakandi or High or Flesh. They're not as accessible a rom-com based.
Something like Dil Bekarar. Yeah.
Something like Dil Bekarar. So I think that's interesting that you put it that way, and I think you might be right. But for me, the decision was more from a craft and an acting perspective.
So was breaking the stereotype a challenge, Akshay?
Yeah, very much, very much. Thanks for asking that. Because it's sometimes you feel like, man, people may not notice that, but you work so hard at that. So I was already stereotyped when I started my career, because I looked a certain way and I felt a certain way. People thought he would play romantic parts from Bandra. That's how it would be. But luckily, that's not how it went. And I got to break it and got to play Haryanvi Jart and, a Bengali fresh trade owner and, all kinds of accents and things like that. So at first it was very difficult. And I'm glad, you noticed that you're asking me that, because that's what you do it.
Right. So I was watching an interview of yours, I think before the second season of Illegal 2 came out. And obviously we have to talk about Flesh. That's probably, one of the most vile characters that we have seen in Indian popular media to come out in a long time. So I remember you saying that I'm a nice person, so it was really hard for me to get into the skin of Taj and do all those wild things. So it took you a while to get into the psyche. But in Dil Bekarar, you seem to be playing a nice, timid guy. So tell me, was it an easier performance?
Actually, when I look at it now, it was a tougher performance.
Dil Bekarar, okay.
Yeah, it is. It's so much harder to play yourself, or to authentically play yourself. I think, I'm already media shy. I'm already Instagram and social media shy. So for me, my natural inkling is to hide behind a mask. In Taj, I had the mask. I was painted. I mean, my hair was white. I had blush. I had lipstick. I had, eyeliner. There was a mask. Those clothes were loud. So I could hide, and then I felt like I could really perform, and be somebody entirely different. With Dil Bekarar, it was more, with Dil Bekarar, it was more me. So then it was hard to be like, oh no, I can't hide. I have to use parts of my natural self. So that became challenging for me in places, because, I was like, how do I do this? I suddenly became conscious. I was like, oh wait, what's happening? How am I so exposed? So it's a much more vulnerable performance for me.
Wow. No, this is a very interesting thing because generally actors tell the other way around. The closer the character is to the real life personality, the easier the performance becomes. But wow.
Absolutely.
What
absolutely.
You said was, wow. So did you read the book? Did you read the book? How did you approach your character?
So actually, Ram, I read it after because Habib Faisal himself is such a good writer. So I knew that he would step in and he understands screenplay and story for the visual format. And taking a novel and converting it, I had a feeling he would have changed a couple of things to make it more accessible for a cinema going audience or a streaming audience. So when I met him for the first time after our first conversation, where it seemed like, okay, I'm going to do this part, I asked him, should I read the book? And he told me, no, don't, because it's a different world. When we finished the show, I had by then discovered how successful this book is. And then I went off and bought a copy and read it. And thank God he asked me not to read it because, you know, if I was a fan of the book, I would be very surprised by my casting. Because the opening line when Dylan is introduced in the book, he's dark, tall, handsome with deep brown eyes. So none of those things are me. Yeah. So I thank God he said that. I think I would have freaked out if I had read that and then showed up on set. I would be like, oh no, I'm all wrong for this part. So thank God I did not read it, but I read it now. So, you know, and it's quite a good read. And I think
did you ask Habib why did they cast you?
Yeah, he actually said I cast you for those eyes. You know, I wanted those eyes. I wanted, and he said that. You know, I think at some point he said that I knew people had not explored this side of you, but I knew it existed. Mm. We've known each other. We've met each other in the past across, you know, along our journey. And he was one of the first guys I actually met when I landed in Bombay and started acting. And he remembers that because he's a very sharp guy. But so he's been kind of watching me go and do my thing. And he was like, I always knew that this kind of lover boy or this kind of charismatic personality was not tapped in you yet. So I think that's why he went with me. I'm glad he did.
How do you think has OTT changed your career, Akshay?
I think I would have been dead without OTT. Because I was doing, you know, one film every year, Lal Rang, Gurgaon, then a Kala Kandi, then, you know, I would wait a bit, Pizza, whatever, all those films. It was like, I would do it, it would release, then I would get another film, then I would do that, then that would release. It was, you know, for me, acting is like, you know, a cricket player has to go out and bat every single day to get better at, you know, batting, you know, so acting is like that. The more you do it, the more you show up on set, the different actors you work with, different directors you work with. So when I saw back a few years ago, the OTT space was opening up and very talented writers and directors were coming into the space, I think I was one of the first entries into it, you know, because I saw there, this can help me season myself as an actor. And it did exactly that. And I'm so fortunate to it, Ram. I can't even tell you because it gave me such interesting parts to play. You know, I would not have, I think what you said about Taj is absolutely correct. In the popular Hindi culture, you know, viewing sort of, you know, this kind of entertainment, you've never seen such a dark character, but the OTT space allowed for him to exist. So it completely evolved my career. And it also evolved the way I think about my career. You know, like I'm no longer hung up on the race. You know, there's always been a race in India for actors. It's like where, you know, horses being bet on that he's number one, he's number two. Yeah, I think OTT did a really good job in shifting that narrative. You know, now it's just actors who work, you know, and the best actors get the, you know, the pick of the litter. So I think that's the big change for OTT for me.
I think when Flesh came out, you had said in an interview that Flesh has to be a very instrumental thing you have done in your career to leave a mark, probably to go to the next step. What do you want Dil Bekarar to do to your career? Or what are you expecting?
Well, you know, I think you put it well for me earlier. I think that now that's really what I feel about it. And I didn't know it. I couldn't articulate it as well until, you know, you showed up and interviewed me. So now I have an answer for it. The answer is that I hope it reaches a wider audience. Because sometimes the work that I do, while critically it is acclaimed and while people appreciate it, I always miss the popular kind of, you know, thing working across a wider audience. And I think this show has that. You know, I think it's the kind of show you can sit and watch with your entire family, which a lot of web series in India, you cannot, you know, there are very few of these. So I think this is very accessible, and I hope that happens. You know, I think Flesh was instrumental from a acting perspective, so that people understood
performance,
so that people understood that what I really care about is not fame and glory. I care about, you know, the craft and acting. That's the reason why I did all these things. But with this one specifically, while I hope all those things are also appreciated, I think more so, I really hope this works with a wide audience.
What's next for you, Akshay?
I have Illegal Season 2 actually releasing a day prior to this. There's Inside It Season 3 releasing on the 3rd of December. And then currently, I'm shooting a movie with Bhatt Saab the Great and Vikram Bhatt called Cold. It's a supernatural love story. And I've had so much fun. Bhatt Saab is incredible. Vikram Bhatt has become like immediately one of my close friends. And I haven't done a horror film since Pizza, and this is a very much a Bhatt film, you know, with all great music and, you know, that kind of thing. So, and it's a totally different space for me, so I've been working on that. And yeah, there's a couple of other things we've signed which eventually we'll talk about, but so it's a nice time. I'm really enjoying myself. I'm having so much fun. This is the part of my career where I feel like the pressure is gone, and I'm having fun finally.
Wonderful. All the best, Akshay. I had a lovely time talking to you. All the best.
Hey, thanks, Ram. Thanks for all the great questions, man.